Last time we learned about the what is the ATP, DPT and INEPT. Today we are going to learn the problems related to the carbon 13 NMR. So let's start with the first problem, that is the molecular formula C5H8O2. Find out the structure of the molecule by given data. Here the first data given over here is 18 quartets, okay, 52 quartet, 126 triplet, 138 singlet and 170 singlet. Okay, here first of all they given us the molecular formula. We have to find out the sites of unsaturation. The sites of unsaturation you already learned in a NMR, H1 NMR spectroscopy. Okay, here how to calculate the sites of unsaturation, which is equal to C plus 1 minus H divided by 2. C means number of carbon, H means the number of hydrogens. See, there are the 5 carbon is there, plus 1 minus 8 hydrogen is there divided by 2. That is 6 minus 4 is equal to what? 2. That means here the sites of unsaturations are 2. Sites of unsaturation indicates the number of double bond present in the molecule. Okay, so there are the two double bond is present in this molecule. Okay, so here there is a carbon 13 data is there. Here first 18 value is there, and this is the, that shows the quartet, splitting its quartet. That means which carbon is there? CH3 carbon is there. Okay, next is that how to find out this quartet. That means here they having a rule, the n plus 1. N means what? Number of hydrogen attached to the, directly attached to the carbon, that is the N. Okay, here how many hydrogen attached to this carbon? There are the 3 hydrogen plus 1 is equal to 4. It gives a 4 value. That means it gives the splitting pattern is the quartet. Okay, next, similar to that, this is having a 52 value, but they gives the quartet, that is also another CH3 is there. Next is 126, you know very well, 122, 140 is value of the carbon-carbon double bond. That means here this triplet carbon, that is CH2 carbon, is must be attached to the carbon-carbon double bond. Okay. Next is 138, this is the singlet carbon, that is C carbon. This is also attached to the carbon-carbon double bond. Okay. And next is 170, this is the highest value. Of chemical shift value, that means this value is indicates this carbon is attached to the ester, that is there is a carbonyl carbon, and this carbonyl is of what? Ester. Okay, that means this is the, this carbon which having a value 170. Okay, so let's start the drawing the structure. First of all, we draw the this esterific compound, that is COO. This is the ester, that means near to that there must be the alkyl group is there. Okay, alkyl group, here there are the two types of alkyl group is there, CH3 having 18 value and CH3 having a 52 value. Then which group is attached to here? The group having a highest value. Why? Because as the electronegativity is increases, their chemical shift value is increases, and that's why here this oxygen is bonded to CH3 group, and the CH3 group having highest value, that is a 52, not the this CH3 which having a 18 value. Why? Because this CH3 is directly attached to the electronegative oxygen. That's why this CH3 value is going to increase. Okay, near to that, here which carbon is there? This C carbon is there. Okay, and this C carbon is directly attached to what? Carbon-carbon double bond, and this carbon-carbon double bond is directly attached to CH2. Okay, then how many carbon is there? 5 carbon. Here there the value of what? 5 carbons. That means all these 5 carbons which having a different environment. Okay, but here 1 2 3 4, only 4 carbon is here we draw. Okay, 1 carbon is remains, and where we fit this carbon? Yes, here. Why? Because this carbon is bonded to only 3 bond. Okay, that's why here this having must be the one bond is there, and this bond is of what? CH3. Why? Because only the this CH3 is remain which having a value 80. Why? Because this carbon is directly attached to this carbon. There is no any electronegative atom. That's why they are having a less value. That is 18. This is the quartet. This is the singlet, and which having a value 138. Why? Because this is attached to the carbonyl carbon. That means their value is going to increase. This is the triplet carbon, which having value 128. Okay, and this is the singlet carbon having value 170, and this is the quartet carbon having the value 52. Okay, like this manner we can find out the structure by given data of carbon 13 NMR spectroscopy. Okay, next here we learn that is next example, that is C8H18. Here also we have to find out their sites of unsaturation, H divided by 2. Okay, here C means number of carbon. Here there are 8 carbon is there, 8 plus 1 minus 18 divided by 2. Okay, 8 plus 1, that is a 9, minus 9 is equal to 0. That means there are the 0 sites of unsaturation. Here in this case, how sites of unsaturation is there? 2 sites of unsaturation. Here the first sites of unsaturation of carbon-carbon double bond, and another sites of unsaturation is of what? Carbon-oxygen double bond. Okay, here the sites of unsaturations are 0, that means there is no any double bond. Okay, here let's move toward the carbon 13 chemical shift value. First is 26. There are how many carbon is there? 8 carbon is there, but they gives us only what? 2 value. That means what? The 2 carbon having a different environment, and remaining all the carbon which is having a same environment. That means here must be symmetry is there. Okay, here the first 26 which shows which type of carbon? CH3 type of carbon. And another, this is having a highest value 35. This is a singlet, that is, this is a this type of carbon. It must be what? The symmetry. That means we first of all draw this carbon-carbon. There is no any sites of unsaturation, no any electronegative atom. That means, and this CH3 group is there. That means this is remaining are the CH3 group attached to the each carbon. You must be solve the problems related to the carbon 13, then only you can find out the structure. Okay, here when we take a plane, then what happen here? This and have a symmetry. This all this CH3 which show the same environment, this is also shows the same environment, A type environment, and this two carbon shows the B type of environment. That's why they gives us only what? The two value. Okay, first value is of what? CH3 which having 26 value, and second is of what? This singlet carbon which having a value what? 35. Okay, this is about what? The examples of the carbon 13 NMR. Okay, now here let's next we take the another example. This is the another example, that is the isomeric alcohol is there which having a molecular formula C4H10O. We have to find out the structure of different alcohol by given carbon 13 data. Okay, here first we have to find out the sites of unsaturation. Okay, which is equal to C plus 1 minus H by 2. C is what? How many C is there? There are 4 C plus 1 minus 10 divided by 2, which is equal to 5 minus 5 is equal to 0. That means how many sites of unsaturation is there? 0. Okay, here sites of unsaturations are 0. Let me see the first data. Here the 33 quartet, that is what? CH3 group is there. This is a 70 value is there, and this is a singlet. That means what? Here the C is must be attached to the OH. Why? Because COH value is about what? 50 to 80. And here there is a 70 value. That means this is a singlet. That means this C is must be attached to the OH. And second is what? How many carbon is there? 4 carbon. But they gives us only 2 value. That means the remaining group having a same environment. That means here this C OH, and here this is attached to what? Remaining this CH3. All this CH3 having a same environment. How many carbon is there? 4 carbon. okay, and here all these having a AA type of splitting signal, and here all these having a same value, that is a 33 quartet. Okay, and this C, which having directly attached to OH, that's why it having a highest value 70. They give us the singlet. Next, this is another isomeric alcohol. Here we learn already the first structure of the alcohol. Let's we start the second isomeric structure. They given us the value 11, which is quartet, 23, which is also quartet. Here 11 they give us quartet, that means the carbon is must be CH3. Here carbon which gives quartet, here this hydrogen, how we calculate it, hydrogen is directly attached to the carbon, and according to n plus 1 rule, 3 hydrogen plus 1, which is equal to 4, and if 4 is there, that is called as a quartet. Next, here there is another value is there, CH23, which also gives the quartet, that means this must be CH3 group. Next is, there is 33 value and they gives a triplet, that means 2 hydrogen is directly attached to the carbon, that means this carbon is CH2. Next to that, they are given us the 68 value, they gives a doublet, that means 1 hydrogen is directly attached to the carbon, that must be CH. And here the value is maximum, that means this CH is directly attached to the electronegative atom, and here the electronegative atom is oxygen. Okay, so try to start to learn the structure of the molecule. Here first of all we draw the CH containing oxygen. Why? Because this oxygen has a maximum value, there is no any sites of unsaturation, that means this is alcoholic, and here this is the isomeric alcohol, that means this CH is directly attached to the OH group. Near to that there is a CH2 is attached, okay, and this CH which having a maximum value, that's why another CH3 is attached to here. Why? Because there is, they given us the two types of CH3, one having a maximum value, another having a low value. Okay, that's why here there is a two different CH3 group is there, one which having a low value and another one having a maximum value. Here why we add only the CH? Because CH2 completed their valency and CH doesn't complete their valency, this completed by addition of the CH3 group. Here the CH2 which having value 33 and the CH3 which having a value 11, and this having a value 11 and this CH3 having value 23. Let's start the another isomeric alcohol. They gives us only 3 value. Why? Because 2 carbon must be having a same environment, okay, and that's why only 3 value is given over here. First is 18, which gives a quartet, that means this carbon is CH3 carbon. Next 32, they gives a doublet, that means this must be CH carbon. And next is 67 value, and they gives triplet, that means this is a CH2 carbon, and which is directly attached to the oxygen or electronegative atom. Okay, so let's start to draw the structure. First of all, this we draw the CH2OH. Why? Because this is the alcohol, and here the CH2 is directly attached to the alcohol. Then near to that, this is the CH group. Okay, and the CH by completing their valency, there is an addition of what? 2 CH3 group. CH2 completed their valency, only CH does not complete their valency, and that's why 2 CH is attached by the CH3 group. That means this CH3, both of this CH3 which we are going to attach to the CH having the same environment, and that's why here they gives the A type of signal, and also another CH3 gives the A type of a signal. Okay, and they have the value 18. Okay, and this CH having a value 32, and the maximum value of CH2 is what? 67. Okay, this is about the third isomeric alcohol.